will learn respect, and suffering will be your teacher.
I looked away.
Uncle? Uncle, is that you?
You're fishing for an octopus, my nephew. You need a tightly woven net, or he will squeeze through the tiniest hole and escape.
I don't need your wisdom right now, Uncle.
I'm sorry. I just nag you because, well, ever since I lost my son.
Uncle, you don't have to say it.
I think of you as my own.
I know, Uncle. We'll meet again. After I have the Avatar.
Remember your breath of fire. It could save your life out there.
I will.
And put your hood up. Keep your ears warm.
I'll be fine. After 3 long years, it's unbelievable.
It is unbelievable. I have never known my brother to regret anything.
Did you listen to Azula? Father's realized how important family is to him. He cares about me.
I care about you. And if Ozai wants you back, well, I think it may not be for the reasons you imagine.
You don't know how my father feels about me. You don't know anything.
Zuko, I only meant that in our family, things are not always what they seem.
I think you are exactly what you seem. A lazy, mistrustful, shallow old man who's always been jealous of his brother.
I think we're safe here.
Nephew.
I've been tracking him, actually.
Is he lost?
Yes, a little bit. His life has recently changed, and he's going through very difficult times. He's trying to figure out who he is, and he went away.
So now you're following him?
I know he doesn't want me around right now, but if he needs me, I'll be there.
Your nephew is very lucky, even if he doesn't know it.
Zuko, I can help!
You're mine now. Uncle?
So, the blue spirit. I wonder who could be behind that mask.
What are you doing here?
I was just about to ask you the same thing. What do you plan to do now that you've found the Avatar's bison? Keep it locked in our new apartment? Should I go put on a pot of tea for him?
First, I have to get it out of here.
And then what? You never think these things through. This is exactly what happened when you captured the Avatar at the North Pole. You had him, and then you had nowhere to go.
I would have figured something out.
No! If his friends hadn't found you, you would have frozen to death.
I know my own destiny, Uncle.
Is it your own destiny? Or is it a destiny someone else has tried to force on you?
Stop it, Uncle. I have to do this.
I'm begging you, Prince Zuko. It's time for you to look inward and begin asking yourself the big questions. Who are you? And what do you want? You did the right thing, nephew. Leave it behind. Got to get out of here. I'll hold them off as long as I can.
I brought you some Komodo chicken. I know you don't care for it, but I figure it beats prison food. I admit it, I have everything I always wanted, but it's not at all how I thought it would be. The truth is, I need your advice. I think the Avatar is still alive. I know he's out there. I'm losing my mind. Please, Uncle, I'm so confused. I need your help. Forget it. I'll solve this myself. Waste away in here for all I care.
What a stunning view.
The only view I'm interested in seeing is the Avatar in chains.
You know, the Avatar hasn't been seen for 100 years. The chances of finding him here are very slim.
First, we'll check each of the air temples. Then we'll scour the world, searching even the most remote locations until we find him.
Prince Zuko, it's only been a week since your banishment. You should take some time to heal and rest.
What else would I expect to hear from the laziest man in the Fire Nation? The only way to regain my honor is to find the Avatar. So I will. Uncle, I know you must have mixed feelings about seeing me, but I want you to know I am so, so sorry, Uncle. I am so sorry and ashamed of what I did. I don't know how I can ever make it up to you, but I... How can you forgive me so easily? I thought you would be furious with me.
I was never angry with you. I was sad because I was afraid you lost your way.
I did lose my way.
You found it again. And you did it by yourself. And I'm so happy you found your way here.
It wasn't that hard, Uncle. You have a pretty strong scent. And then would you come and take your rightful place on the throne?
No. Someone new must take the throne. An idealist with a pure heart and unquestionable honor. It has to be you, Prince Zuko.
Unquestionable honor? But I've made so many mistakes.
Yes, you have. You struggled, and you suffered. But you have always followed your own path. You restored your own honor. And only you can restore the honor of the Fire Nation.
I'll try, Uncle.
I wish I could talk to Aang.
You know, Zuko and Aang were close friends.
Lord Zuko, of course.
Yes, my nephew. Their relationship started off a little rocky, but they grew to become lifelong friends. Best friends.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You're right about the spirit world. I came here looking for someone else, but I'm glad I found you.
Did you find Zaheer?
No, he wasn't there. But there's someone I need to talk to. You're leaving? Aren't you coming to the Air Temple with us?
I'm sorry, but I can't. I'm going back to the Fire Nation. If it's true that the Red Lotus is targeting the nation's leaders, I need to protect my daughter.
I understand. You have to keep the Fire Lord safe. But before you leave, I was wondering if you could help me with something.
I was often Aang's counsel, and I'd love to be yours.
That's just it. You knew Aang better than anyone. I was wondering if you knew what he might do if he were in my situation.
Rebuilding the Air Nation was Aang's biggest dream. He would be beside himself with joy with what you've done. And if he accomplished that goal, he might have sacrificed anything to protect it.
So he would give himself up to save the Air Nation?
I don't know for sure. The Airbenders might have been closest to Aang's heart, but as the Avatar, he was concerned with people of all nations. No one knew better than Aang that in times of turmoil, the world needs its Avatar the most.
Thanks. Your uncle was right. It was helpful talking to you.
Wait. You spoke with my uncle?
Yes. In the spirit world. A couple of times, actually.